Hey guys, I'm Cementos Ken. We're about to play a game that's really weird. It's like up there with like the weirdest games ever. It's called Harvester. And if you liked I Have No Mouth But I'm a Scream, then you'll probably like this game. And I haven't played this myself, but I was looking through, like I Googled it before, like I did a little bit of research before I started playing the game. There's like blood on the street there. No kids in the classroom. But it's weird. Like, unless those thumbnails are off in like one spot in the game, then it should be pretty good. What is this? Going into the mansion, maybe. Ooh, between the legs. That's where I like it. There's a lot of candles on the floor. This seems to be a fire hazard. Into a hole down the only hallway in this mansion. Into a mutilated body. Future Vision presents an Ann Lee Jacobson production, a Gilbert Austin game. How many more names can we put in this? Harvester. Oh yeah, and I'm sure it's got like the whole freaking cast here. Oh, we're going to the H. Here we go. Oh, now we're going to a house right outside the mansion. And there's a picture of a girl. An alarm clock. It's 7 a.m. Oh, the alarm's going off. Oh, I'm naked. Oh, perfect hair in the morning. That crinkly back. Hot. Put that jacket on. Those Michael Jackson shoes. I love this green screen stuff. Please wait. Okay, I can wait. Hey, here we are in our beautiful home with some nice sound going on and full of hardbacks near the lower shelf. So this must be my room. Is that the binoculars? Pair of plastic binoculars. Pills? Acne medicine. Empty container. Oh no! What else we got? Is this a clarinet? Obviously some fat high school girl left it. What? Oh, Gabe! You are so mean! I don't even want to look at the other stuff as a chair. What about the mirror? Peer through. I do know we can attack. Huh! Punch! Right! Punch the carpet! You show that carpet who's boss. Just gotta right click and just punch away. So apparently there's combat in this game. Who knows how that's gonna work? The drawer is unlocked. Check out the... Oh, it changed. Are there a bunch of pills in this drawer? What is that? Examine the quarter. Ah, dated 1952. Pick it up. What is this? A ballpoint pen. I'll take that. How about them sunglasses? As of yet, the future isn't so bright. Can I see these pills? Pills here. All right. Now that's all I can do. Let's go in here and see what's up. Hey, little boy. Look at that TV. Is that a crack in the ceiling or something hanging down? I can't tell. Talk to Hank.
What?
Voice acting. I guess I don't know who I am. Where am I?
In the doghouse if you keep bugging me. Because I'm sick. And I'll tell Mom if you don't let me watch TV.
Okay. Except that TV.
That's a weird looking television. Come to think of it, this whole place looks totally retro.
Retro. All TVs look alike.
Sure, basically. But this is one old-fashioned clunker.
Old-fashioned? It's brand new.
Yeah, but look at the tube.
Brand new. It's like
where's
his feelings are hurt.
Control?
What's that?
Now that I think about it, I can't remember.
And what was that you said about retro rockets?
No, retro. It means... Oh man, I know what I mean. That everything here is wrong. But I can't picture the difference.
Then shut up and quit bugging me. I'm watching my cowboy show.
Well, how about that cowboy show? Tell me about it.
Have you noticed that your show is in black and white?
What else? Color? On a TV?
I've traveled in time!
I think I've seen a color television before.
Have not. Quit it or I'm gonna tell.
Hey, look at that. Your mother lets you watch this stuff?
Sure. This is part of history. What made America great.
Made America
besides,
great.
Besides, Blood and guts are neato.
Blood and guts are neato, huh? You're right. That's really neat.
I'm glad you're catching on, Steve. You're not too bad for a lousy rat.
I don't know if I just got threatened or not. I'm not really too sure. Okay. Bye.
Good. Finally.
All right. Well, whatever. Is this an exit? Let's get out of here before he kills us. Oh, hey. Mom. Ooh, some cookies over there. That baby? I want to look at the baby. A newborn is sleeping soundly. You mess with him? Okay, fine. Whatever. What's up, Mom?
Well, hello there. How about some cookies? There's plenty of rejects in the trash.
Who are you?
That's a fine
what?
Way to talk to your
Just tell
mother.
Me to eat.
You're my mother?
Eat cookies out of
That's
the trash?
Right, though sometimes I get treated like the hired help around here.
I don't remember you.
Of course you don't. Until you need your socks washed.
No, you don't understand. I can't remember where I am or even who I am.
Land's sake, stop your joshing, won't you? Honestly, Steve, I thought you'd grow up a little after graduation.
Oh, graduate.
I only hope that new job will plant your feet on the ground.
So that's my name. Steve.
Steve.
Your name will be M-U-D Mud if you don't stop teasing me, young man.
Listen, this may sound strange, but I've lost my memory. Do you believe me?
Heck no.
Well, you always were a kidder, Steve.
I'm serious.
Sure, and next you'll be telling me you don't remember Hank and your little sister.
Ooh, we got a sister?
Sister?
Shh, you'll wake her. I just put her down to
sleep.
Hey,
baby.
If she wakes up, she'll
just
want to eat again.
Is that a bug? I mean, of course it's a spider.
Darn it, I'm busy, and if you think I'm going to play along with this nonsense, you're crazier than Spider.
Mom, there's like a freaking spider in the baby's
Fine.
Thing.
Maybe I am crazy. I can't rule that out. Why can't you just help me a little? Is that too much to ask?
Now you've done it. Are you happy? Poor baby.
Poor baby.
There. Did your brother scare you? Let me see.
What the? It ain't the spider? No, oh, you slapped the baby?
You're that white woman. She's a monster. That's what she is.
My baby sister's a monster. Oh, man, this is turning out to be a fantastic game so far. How about that wasp?
Wasp woman?
Bet you a crumb is going to hear about this. I want you to go to her house right now and give her a piece of my mind.
I don't know where she lives.
Honestly, you can't miss a house covered with paper nests. Steve, you tell her to mind her own beeswax, or by golly, I'll take it up with the PTA. Or the lodge.
Lodge. What's up with the PTA?
What's the PTA got to do with anything?
Show some respect, Steve. The PTA has a lot of clout in Harvest. We run the charity bake sale, the annual blood drive, and by gosh, we even have ties to the lodge.
Okay. Blood drive. Let's talk about that.
Annual blood drive, huh?
If you knew how much blood we get, you'd be more impressed. Donations are mandatory, Steve. If you're still here come Sunday, you'll be expected to give.
Until it hurts, I suppose.
If I'm still here on Sunday?
Even Hank will have to donate. Of course, lodge members are exempt. Remember that.
Hey, either way, no one's sticking
it's
me
like
with a needle.
Like a serious talk she just
we
had
don't
with me.
We use needles.
Well, okay. How about Hank?
Hank. That kid over by the television?
Your little brother is homesick from school today, and I won't have you scaring him with this amnesia poop.
Is he really sick?
Look at the show he's watching. Wouldn't you say he's sick? I'd make him stop, but I'm so busy baking cookies for the Harvest
Killing
PTA
show,
charity
yeah.
bake sale. It's on Friday, you know. I hope you're still planning on going.
I don't know. I need to think.
Honestly, skipping out of a charity affair. What's gotten into you?
I know, I'm terrible.
I don't know, damn it, that's what I'm telling you.
Don't you dare use that language around me. You're lucky your father didn't hear you. Or Stephanie, for that matter. How do you think she'd feel knowing her fiancé was a...
I have a fiancé. Actually, tell me about my dad. Where's he at?
My father.
He's in the other room. He decided to sleep in today. Now, please, let me get back to my cookies.
Stephanie? Steph.
Stop speaking nonsense, dear.
Come on. Girlfriend.
Stop speaking nonsense, dear.
I want to know about her. I can tell about the cookies, fine.
The bake sale is on Friday, and yet you're baking the cookies now.
Never put off till tomorrow what you can do today.
But they'll be stale by then.
That's why I'm throwing them away.
And then cooking more?
To replace the ones I throw out.
Why?
Well, I have to. No one's going to pay to eat stale cookies out of the garbage can.
But you expect me to?
Of course not, Steve. I wouldn't charge you. I'm your mother. Help yourself.
Okay. Goodbye,
Don't
Mom.
Forget to put the papers out for Jimmy. You know how he gets.
The papers out for Jimmy. Okay, whatever. There's a lot of cookies in the trash can. Well, this is awkward, Mom. Where's the paper at? Is that her? Oh, yeah, I do have. There it is. Newspaper. Okay. Well, good. Sweet. We gotta give Jimmy the newspaper. Newspaper. Use newspaper on Jimmy.
Hey, Steve, I'm Jimmy James. Remember me?
I guess not.
Hey, Steve, you've been doing a swell job putting the paper out in the morning. You just keep doing that and we won't have any problems. That's not much to ask, is it?
Are you threatening me too? Jimmy?
See you later, alligator.
Okay. You're welcome, Jimmy. Apparently, if I don't give the news... Why do I have to give him the newspaper in the morning? That's kind of backwards, right? Right? Yeah. Let's get the heck out of here before something crazy happens. All right, so now... Oh, I just clicked back on my house. Oh, Jimmy's gone. This is a map. I thought I could, like, scroll, but apparently I... Oh, yeah, you can. You just, like... Yeah, well, there's a cemetery. This is a pretty big map. I guess I'm just going to have to go around and, like, discover all these areas. Or, like, go and look around until I find something. So, there's going to be a lot of jump cuts. But so far, this game is pretty cool. All right, let's see. Oh, my gosh. Okay, I just went into the barber shop, and there's, like, a freaking crazy red-eyed sheep back there. Except for its occasional hairball cough, it's hard to tell if the sheep is alive or not. Apparently it is, and it's insane. who am I supposed to be talking to in here? Talk to the visitors. Oh.
Howdy, Steve.
Yeah. Howdy back, Mr.
Pete Swell, Steve. Don't you pull my old leg now. Change your mind about that aluminum siding?
What are you talking about?
I really think you should talk your father into buying some. He can afford it. And I can't stress enough the value of some really fine aluminum siding. Keeps it warm in the summer, cool in the winter, and it keeps out the sheep. Pastorelli ought to look into some, but I can't get him to understand a word I say.
He just said, like, aluminum siding, it keeps it warm in the summer and cool in the winter. Isn't that backwards? What about that
can't
sheep?
I understand why Pastorelli keeps that nasty thing in here. Must remind him of the pastures in Italy. Kinda like why I keep wrenches under my pillow. So as I can dream about plumbing.
Alright, you dream about plumbing? Alright, how about Pastorelli?
Pastorelli's a rube from way back.
A rube.
Ask Clem Parsons how we followed up with the alarm system in here. I'm a plumber. I could fix it for him, but he just won't listen.
Alright, tell me about plumbing.
Well, I seen
Get excited.
Plumbing for the aluminum siding game. So I took a mail course and learned how to be a plumber. Now, there's a business that never lets up. You'd be surprised what people flush down the toilet.
Huge turds, right? Alright, you're...
Nice to see you again, Steve.
Cray, how about Mr. Parsons?
Hello there, youngster. You say them aliens I was telling you about?
What?
They came back last night. Cut another crop circle in my south field.
How come I never seen none of them saucers, Clam?
Them aliens is wildly, Pete. You don't cross the intergalactic void without learning a trick or two. You know what Pastorelli did? Yesterday, he gets an alarm system to protect his pole. Only he don't know how to rig it, so now it's all awry.
How about them aliens? Now, you're not going to tell me about that. What about the pole? What is that?
Why, that barber's pole of his is his pride and joy. Brought it all the way over from Italy, wrapped all special-like.
Wow.
It ain't nothing but colored glass with some bulbs stuck up in it. Buddy thinks it's the be-all end-all. Installed that alarm system just to protect it. Though who in tarnation would want to steal a worthless piece of junk like that? I don't know.
Maybe them aliens, Clem.
Oh, Pete, don't be ignorant. Them aliens don't give a fig for no colored glass. You think if they can build spaceships, they can't make a dadgum barber pole? Crazy hick don't know nothing about science.
Tell me about those aliens.
Well, son, the ways of the alien is a specialized area of woodcraft unknown to all but the wiliest sportsmen. What you gotta remember is, your average alien is smarter than your average human. So you gotta be extra careful building your blind if you want to bag one.
You hunt aliens.
Son, after nailing an alien, you can never go back to quail. What? You think you can get one of those at a swap meet?
What? There's an alien out on the wall?
Line your blind with lead to fool their sensing machines. Lay real quiet and wait. Preferably in the woods around the nuclear base. Oh, they love messing around out there.
Why not wait outside your field, Clem? Wait for them to come a-carving.
Oh, they do their crop doodles with zap guns, you darn fool. Don't you know nothing? Besides, ain't no place to put the blind out in the field. Now, you listen to Clem Parsons if you want to tag an unearthly being.
They cross the void. Wondering what lies beyond, all the time not knowing that what awaits them is
buckshot.
Okay. We'll see you later.
Anytime.
How about Mr. Pastorelli? What do you have to say about life? He doesn't respond, understanding. Okay. Oh, there's the alien right there. Unfortunate ex-Tracely who journeyed hundreds of light years to wind up mounted on the barber's wall. What? Oh, man. That was surprising. I wasn't expecting that.
Speaking of willies, how's your father?
Wait.
Don't know.
Speaking of willies,
care to buy anything
how's
today?
Your father? What? Oh, wait, what? Did she? Wait, what? What kind of,
Just point to whatever you want. I'm a little hard of hearing.
Okay. Let's examine the shelf then. Variety of odd and let's see. Cigarette. Rich. What is that? The adult magazine. Is that a butt? Oh, 25 cents. You must pay Miss Phelps before you can buy anything. Yeah, the only thing about the quarter is an adult magazine.
A girly magazine? Why, Steve, I'm surprised at you. I'd expect that sort of thing from Deputy Loomis, but never from you. He's always coming in here oogling the girly magazines behind my counter. Darned if I'd sell him one, though. I know his wife, for heaven's sake.
Well, will you sell me one?
I certainly will, Steve.
Oh, yeah.
That kind of interest is healthy for a young fellow. Steers him away from being a fireman.
A fireman? Is that another word for homosexuality back in the day? A fireman? I don't know. Give me that magazine, girl. I already have it. Good! Now I can get to reading it. I need to use it on myself, please. Aw, put it back in my inventory. It looks like it's sort of like a slapped butt. Can I make a copy of it?
Okay. Well, that didn't work.
Well, fine. Shut up. Whatever. Oh, hello there, Mr. Potsdam. You are a sexy fellow.
There he is, my future son-in-law.
Oh!
And how's he doing today? What brings him to the Potsdam household, huh?
I'm just investigating. Came over to see Stephanie. Oh! Ah, oh, clicked. I didn't get to see. Meat?
Meat is the foundation of any decent society.
Look at his face, he's like,
everyone needs at least 3 servings of red meat a day. And anyone who says otherwise is a commie. And once you're married to Stephanie, I'll be part of the family too. And your father will give me all the meat I want. kind of makes up for not getting into the lodge.
Wait. What? Is that meat on the wall? Yeah. Tell me about...
I haven't seen my father.
Look at that. It's like a big steak.
He's not going to die, is he?
Well, I hope not.
Like I said, I don't know. That woman, Mom, tends to him herself.
Well, next time you see him, be sure to tell him that I said hello. And tell him that I'm praying for his speedy recovery. And also, would you remind him about the meat? Especially about the meat.
Yeah, fine.
Okay.
If I see him.
You should be more concerned. If he dies, then who's going to take over the slaughterhouse? Who's going to tend to the meat? I guess as his son, you'd take over. Right?
So my dad is the butcher of the town.
I can't imagine a better job than working in a slaughterhouse.
Yeah, it would be cool.
Sure, it'd be just dandy. You can't argue with success. Everyone in Harvest gets their meat from your dad. What a grand business to go into.
All right.
Oh, sure.
God dang it.
Cutting animals open may not be much fun. Reaching into their bodies and yanking out the bloody guts, intestines dangling and slapping against you, the smell of death and shit in your nostrils all the time. Well, those are all definite cons. But once you're done, the guts have been washed into the gutters.
What was that?
What are you left with?
That scared the crap. It's like...
rows and rows of scrumptious...
Did you hear that?
Red.
Okay, I'm going to not talk to you because that huge popping noise that just happened scared my balls off. She's purdy. Serious? She's purdy. This is hanging a bit crooked. Oh my. Oh my. Those hips don't lie. Good one, Steve. High five, buddy. You did it. Can we have it again? Can I do it again? Oh, yeah. Watch it again. Put that shirt right back on. All right. So that. Oh, jeez. All right, girl. I was just checking you out through your hole in the wall, which, why is that hole in the wall there now that I think about it? And it's already oh, my gosh. Bad. It's been watching. No. Okay. What's up, girl?
Who are you? What are you doing in my room?
Oh.
Haven't you heard? We're getting married.
You don't know me?
So, you're the one. Steve, isn't it?
You mean you don't know me?
I mean I don't know anyone. I don't remember anything. How many times do I have to say it?
Just one, Stephanie, because I can't remember a damn thing either.
Really? Oh, God, I thought it was just me.
You're not alone. Can you tell me what's going on here?
Those people downstairs have locked me in my room. They say I'm grounded until the wedding.
Hmm. Tell me about the wedding, girl.
The wedding is only 3 weeks away. Not much time to get to know each other, is it?
Hmm.
No?
If it comes down to it, we just won't take the vows.
I don't think anything in Harvest is that simple. Too many people are determined that we get hitched.
Why?
Potsdam wants the meat your father promised him. Your parents want to force you to settle down. Mrs. Potsdam wants to have the wedding in the lodge. Me? I just want to escape.
Hmm. How do we escape?
Escape?
Harvest is a prison, Steve. Don't forget that.
Okay. I think you're right.
Of course I'm right.
Okay, of course you are. How about the amnesia?
Maybe my amnesia isn't total after all. You're familiar to me. Like we've met before. In another life.
Oh, I was just watching you through the hole in your wall.
Maybe we really do live here. Maybe we were together, and the same thing happened to both of us. An accident. Something.
Neither of us has bumps on our heads, if that's what you're getting at.
Have you been able to remember anything else? Anything at all?
Well, I have had these recurring dreams. Just fragments, really. Strange, abstract images. Liquid, chrome.
Probably just a dream.
Well, have you thought about how to escape Harvest?
Not really.
Escape?
Harvest is a...
Okay. Yeah, I think you're right. Amnesia. Think about the lodge.
Everything in Harvest seems to revolve around this damned lodge. This Order of the Harvest Moon. They're responsible for this insane bake sale that's coming, and for the Harvest Blood Drive, too. When people talk about the lodge, it's always in this hushed, reverent tone.
Oh!
Mom keeps telling me that women can't join, but she keeps pressuring me to get you to join.
Interesting. Maybe if I want answers, I should go right to the source and get a membership application.
That's probably the worst thing you could do.
You think the lodge is some kind of trap?
I think all of Harvest is a trap.
If that's true, maybe joining the lodge is the way out.
Look, why not explore the town a little? I can't get out of here, but if I could, that's what I'd do. Maybe you can figure out what's happening here without going anywhere near the lodge.
You're really afraid of the lodge, aren't you?
I look at that building, all lit up at night, and I get scared.
Nope, she's looking at it again.
I mean, look at the damn thing. Seem like a harmless bunch of masons to you?
Tell me about your dad.
You're not making sense.
Your father, maybe.
You're not making sense.
Hole in the wall.
You're not making sense.
Naked.
You're not making sense.
Come on.
Come back and visit me soon, okay?
Okay.
Steve, it's good to talk to you, but if...
I was just, you know, trying to see what else you would say.
Come back and visit me soon, okay?
Okay. Well, we found her. It's probably a good spot to pause right here. So far, things are looking pretty weird in town. I've only been to like a quarter of the buildings I can go into. And everything's weird. But we found Stephanie, and she's like, hey, I don't know what's going on either. So that's a step in the right direction, I think. Anyway, see you guys next time. If today's your birthday, happy birthday. And stay toasty, my friends.